Until now, we have talked about two concepts to characterize an emission reduction options. These are potentials and costs. How much can emissions be reduced, and how much does it cost? Now, I will explain how these two elements can be combined in one visualization. We call this graph a marginal abatement cost curve, also abbreviated as MACC or MAC curve. Let's go back to the example of the installation of the photovoltaic system on a house. We saw that installation of such a system will avoid 1.2 tons of CO2 emissions per year, and it will cost $82 per ton of CO2 avoided. You can present this as a rectangle in which the width gives the avoided emissions and the height gives you the cost per ton of CO2. But there will be other options to reduce CO2 emissions. For example, this one with somewhat lower costs. And there will be more with varying potentials and varying costs. Each of them can in the same way be represented by a rectangle. What we now do is to organize them from cheap to expensive. So we start at the left with the option with the lowest costs. Now we get a visual overview of how much you can in total reduce emissions and what cost levels you should accept for a given emission reduction. So this is how typically a marginal abatement cost curve is constructed. Here again is an example of a marginal abatement cost curve where the emphasis is more on the outline than on the individual options. What you initially see in this graph is that the cost of options can be negative, so the curve can start below zero. This is no surprise, as some options may have receivables that are larger than the costs. The basic thing is that on the horizontal axis you see cumulative emission reduction and on the vertical axis you see the marginal costs of emission reduction or marginal abatement costs. The graph can be used in two ways. First, if you wish to avoid an amount A of emissions, you need to take measures with cost until level B. Conversely, you can also determine how much emissions you avoid if you take all measures below a certain cost level. For example, in this case, if you would take all the emission measures that are cheaper than C, you would avoid an amount D of emissions. In the very beginning of the series of videos, we defined the economic potential. And here we have it. In the determination of the economic potential, we take external costs into account. Here we see that if a value of C is given to avoided greenhouse gas emissions, the economic potential is D. You see that the economic potential can strongly depend on the value of avoided CO2 emissions. Let me now give you some real-world examples of marginal abatement cost curves. This is a marginal abatement cost curve for vegetable oil production in the Netherlands. It is a relatively small industrial sector within the food industry, but with a serious emission impact. In this sector, all kinds of edible oils are produced from feedstocks like palm oil, rapeseed, and soybean. All the options together can lead to an emission reduction of 100% of the initial emissions. It starts on the left with a number of energy efficiency measures, denoted with their respective abbreviations, and these are often relatively cheap, indicated by the negative costs. Then there are some supply options. For instance, biogas can be produced as a byproduct and then used for heating processes. But at a given moment, all these cheaper options are exhausted. You need to go to the more expensive options. And ultimately, in this case, you need to install an electric boiler driven by renewable energy sources to cover the rest of the heat demand of the process. So this is how a marginal abatement cost curve can look in real life. You see very low cost options, but also options that are very expensive. The highest cost intervention would have an associated cost of slightly more than €150 per avoided ton of CO2. Let's move on to a follow-up example. This one is completely different. It is a marginal abatement cost curve for the entire world, valid for 2030. It's probably one of the most famous of such graphs. It was developed by consultancy firm McKinsey in 2009. They were the first to develop a MAC curve for the entire world. So you see a similar pattern. A lot of options with negative costs. You will see them specified individually. Again, you see many energy efficiency options are relatively cheap. Also, there are options included outside the energy sector, for instance, waste recycling and rice management. You also see options gradually becoming more expensive. Some options require more cost, for example, nuclear energy and solar PV. At the time this curve was constructed, the latter technology was still relatively expensive. Finally, a number of options with carbon capture and storage, abbreviated as CCS, belong to the most expensive ones. Thus, to summarize, the marginal abatement cost curve is a very simple and attractive tool to visualize what can be done about greenhouse gas emission reduction, whether it's a small company, a municipality, a country, or as you see here, even the entire world. Okay, having said this, marginal abatement cost curves do have some noteworthy issues. One of them is that options influence each other. For example, in the electricity sector, if you have more solar energy, this may mean that less wind energy is feasible and vice versa. Furthermore, potentials and costs will change with time. We already flagged the cost reduction of solar photovoltaic energy. But also due to improved efficiency and performance of technologies, we will see variations over time. Finally, there will always be variation in costs. They may be different in different situations. For example, the cost of solar energy will differ country by country due to differences in level of insulation. Another example of cost differences may be caused by scale effects, e.g., small and large companies may have different cost levels for the same technology. Despite these drawbacks, if you are aware of these limitations and aware that MAC curves are always a simplification, such marginal abatement cost curves can be a useful tool to visualize potentials and costs for emission reduction.